The Philippines' top economist reaffirms government's commitment to creating more jobs following that slight uptick in the unemployment rate. NEDA Secretary Arsenio Balisacan highlights government's infrastructure push, which is expected to generate more jobs. Balisacan adds the Marcos administration is ready to assist Filipino workers in the digital age by upskilling them. A 2023 study by a global management consultancy has found at least 50,000 local jobs are at risk of becoming obsolete in the next 3 to 4 years due to rapid digitalization. The Agriculture Department defending government's move to lower the tariff on imported rice. Farmers groups have criticized the decision to slash imported rice tariff from 35 to 15% for the next 4 years, with no assurance prices of the staple grain will go down. But the DA insists this will lead to cheaper rice as early as July.
Pag binaba mo yung taripa, directly mag re-redown yung benefit sa general public. Kasi bababa, kung titingnan natin yung computation ng PSA, 6 to 7 pesos yan. Napakalaking kabawasan yan doon sa existing prices ngayon ng imported na well milled at 52 pesos.
The new CFO of Philippine broadband provider Converge ICT looks to herald the company's next phase of their revolution. The seasoned investment banker Robert Leo Yu touted Thursday the over 8 million fiber ports that Converge has installed across the country. Yu is calling it an exciting time for the company as it looks to tap data centers to support its needs and as it explores cloud offerings for its customers. He adds network expansion efforts will continue, but the days of just setting higher capital expenditures may be a thing of the past for the company now.
We have wired a lot of homes in the Philippines. We have 8 million ports, of which we're utilizing 25%. So our goal is we need to start utilizing the ports. Mm. We've invested a lot into our network already. We will continue to invest in our network, but the days of just opening ports and high capex are behind us, given that we're already 90% homes passed. Outperformance in Q1 earnings is a result of all the initiatives that our founders have put in place and the strong work that the management team has done over the last several months.
Two Philippine companies confirm reports of data breaches in their company and are now under evaluation by the country's National Privacy Commission. Real estate firm Robinson's Land reported a data breach to the NPC on June 1. Car manufacturing giant Toyota, meanwhile, says it was hit by a data breach last May 14. These follow the 6 instances of cyber hacking that victimized the Philippine National Police last month. The NPC says it is monitoring the situation to ensure the security and privacy of all subjects of data breaches. Another company inches closer to making its stock market debut. The Securities and Exchange Commission approves the initial public offering of renewable energy developer NextGen. The firm secured the green light for its planned offering of up to 300 million common shares at 1 peso and 68 centavos apiece. An overallotment option of up to 45 million common shares was also set at the same price. NextGen expects to net up to 478 million pesos from the IPO to help fund its projects. The Philippine Stock Exchange had said the company plans to list its shares by July. NextGen could be the third IPO at the local bourse this year. And to our next item, also in the energy space, Citicor Renewable. C-REC of Ed Saavedra rings the bell at the PSE tomorrow, Friday, for the listing of its 1.78 billion common shares at 2 pesos and 70 pesos apiece. Meanwhile, Robinson's Land Corporation enters into a property for share swap deal with its commercial real estate investment trust. This involves 11 Robinson's malls and 2 office assets in Quezon and Davao City to diversify the RLC's office asset portfolio. This raises to 827,000 square meters RL Commercial REIT's total gross leasable space. RLC will also subscribe to 34 billion pesos worth of shares of RL Commercial REIT. Also from the Gokongwei Group, Cebu Pacific taps a local flight training school for its cadet pilot program. Setback signed today, a deal with Airworks Aviation to formalize the partnership. The Cadet Pilot Initiative is a 96-week program to train candidates to become licensed commercial pilots. And finally, ASIN Corporation hikes its subscription of shares to its unit, Giga Ace 8. This has a price tag of 2.17 billion pesos to help fund Giga Ace's proposed solar project in Zambales Province.